Hello everyone! Today we're doing another analysis video on Mike Wheeler, specifically the gay-coded music for Mike Wheeler.
We're going to focus on one song used in particular in a scene, and the rest from his official Spotify playlist.
So let's start off with the scene. So this is from season 1, episode 3. This is right after the kids have discovered Will's body.
It's not Will. It can't be.
We can beat them forever and ever.
Interestingly enough, we are really only shown Mike's perspective on this. The song used in this scene is called Heroes by Peter Gabriel. It's a cover of the David Bowie song released in 1977. The reason that this song really stuck out to me as gay-coded is because of the meaning of the song, what the song is actually about. So Heroes is about two lovers, one from East Berlin and the other from West. Under constant fear of death, they dream they are free, swimming with dolphins. The original title was actually placed in quotation marks as an expression of the irony over the otherwise romantic and triumphant words of the music. The version we hear in Stranger Things is more melancholy. It's more dragged out, it's kind of breathy, there's a lot of pauses. The music slowly brings up to almost triumphant, but it's like kind of sad build up to it. And it's just more somber. The fact that we have this song used in this specific scene is really interesting because it is used again in season 3 towards the end, where we see Joyce sacrifice Hopper to save everyone else, basically. Now, obviously, we as people who have seen Stranger Things know that both of these deaths were false, but if we're going off the context of the song, this song is inherently romantic.
And the guns!
Michael?
Shout above our heads! And we kissed as though nothing could fall.
And the shame was on the other side.
Even more context. One of the main reasons that people were saying around town that Will went missing and probably was dead was because he was queer. Mike never stopped looking for him, regardless of what he was bullied for, which probably extended to himself.
Will's in fairyland now, right?
Being his best friend. These lyric choices at these specific moments seem extremely intentional to me.
All happy and gay.
And the gun shot above our heads can literally translate to all the bullying that they face for being gay. And we kissed as though nothing could fall, meaning their romance, or their friendship in this case, was still strong. And the shame. So at this first part, then it cuts to the buyers, but this first part is on Mike. And if you guys have seen my theories, I talk about a lot how Mike has internalized homophobia, especially when he gets a little bit older. So this line choice is very specific to that. And it cuts to the buyers and it says, "The shame is on the other side." This is referring to Will. One, it's a double meaning. It can mean he's dead. And two, the shame, him being gay, is the other side. To point out that the original version of the song is actually quite happy and triumphant sounding, so I wouldn't be surprised if they bring this back for season 5 if these two actually get together.
Who would you rather be friends with? Bowie or Kenny Rogers?
Oh,
exactly. It's no contest.
And now let's move on to Mike's Spotify playlist. So there is a few character playlists that you can listen to. They have fun insights into the character and their plot lines in the story. To bear in mind that most of these songs do not show up in the show, it's just for fun. I asked you guys your opinions on some of these songs, and I wanted to highlight some of these that are very gay-coded for Mike. So let's start. Very first song on Mike's playlist is quite literally Small Town Boy, and if you know anything about this song, it is very gay. So Small Town Boy was released in 1984, and it is a heartfelt cry for gay liberation. This semi-autobiographical song flagged up the need for gay men to flee small town intolerance and pursue reinvention in the big city. Interestingly enough, 1984 is when season 2 takes place, and it's also the same year that Mike and Will develop crushes on each other. So we have lyrics like, "Mother will never understand why you had to leave, but the answers you seek will never be found at home." pushed around and kicked around, always a lonely boy. You were the one that they'd talk about around town as they put you down. And as hard as they would try, they'd hurt to make you cry, but you never cried to them. I really like this because this really applies to Mike. You could argue that this applies to Will too, but when it gets to that they'll never see you cry part, that is very much Mike. Because we know, as viewers, that Mike is suffering.
So alone and so scared. But I saw you on the swings, and you were alone too.
But he never shows his tears to anyone except Will. There are so many songs on Mike's playlist that have to do with running away. Now, this running away metaphor can mean from his actual feelings, which is what I honestly think is what it is, because there's also songs on this playlist that allude to him being unhappy in a relationship, but I digress. There is an ongoing theme in Mike's playlist of running away. This song was strongly pointed out to me. Our friend's electric. I mean, you can kind of tell by the title of this song, but I mean, I also looked it up and it's apparently about a robot prostitute, so, you know, we're gonna do some metaphors here.
So now I'm alone. Now I can think for myself about little deals and issues and things that I just don't understand. A white lie that night or a sly touch at times. I don't think it meant anything to you. So I opened the door. It's the friend that I left in the hallway. You Leave was also suggested to me by several people saying that it paralleled happened in season 3. And this playlist was created around the same time, so it makes sense.
Well, I was just messing around.
Also, on this playlist, there's a few songs that allude to hiding in the closet, like Cars, for example.
Here in my car, I feel safest of all. I can lock all my doors. It's the only way to live in cars. So this one is about, like, locking yourself up and hiding yourself. Here in my car, I can only receive. I can listen to you. It keeps me stable for days in cars. So again, you can interpret this as, I'll only listen to one person, but I'm still locking myself up to keep myself safe, normal, and in my comfort zone.
Also, they just happen to have this cover art for this specific song that says Celebrate Gay Pride. I mean, I don't know if that was intentional, but I'm gonna just put it here. Honestly, that just scratches the surface of this playlist. I highly recommend going and checking it out yourself. Tell me what you guys think of these songs and how you interpret them for Mike's character. I'd love to hear it. Thanks to everyone who left comments on my story the other day when I was asking about this, and I hope you guys enjoyed the video. See you in the next one. Bye bye!